I'd like to report as regards train operations. For this year, we ran, we will have run May 24th through October 19th. It's 149 continuous days, two train operations. We ran 10 sunset dinner trains. We had two preseason charters that we operated out of Antonito and two multiple day charters we have operated out of Chama. There will be one postseason charter out of Chama. We additionally ran five engineer schools and over 20 steam-powered work trains this year. So we have operated over 350 steam-powered trains. Highlights, we had double-headed trains out of both depots for the first time on opening day of this year. We have double-headed 15 trains this year. No trains have been canceled or failed to make their complete trips. There were only four locomotive breakdowns during the course of the season. 484, which had a governor, an air compressor governor problem. The 487, which had a hot driver. The 489, which had a piston ring failure. And the 463, which had some spring rigging pin failures. All of those were taken care of. We did not have to cancel or delay any trips. Our ridership is expected to end up on the positive side of 33,000. That is down from last year by about 2.5%. We did operate 10 dinner trains this year and hauled 894 people on those. We have modified the product that we do for the Cinder Bear and have changed it from a 6-train experience to 18 operating days, reducing the operating costs and improving the availability for kids and their parents to experience the product. We've completed the Y in Chama, and with the completed Y, we can now turn an entire train at once, and that has allowed us to bring a train in just after 4 o'clock, get it turned, serviced, and loaded to be a dinner train, and out in under an hour. Another thing that we have accomplished is the conversion of two cars to be ADA access and concession cars, so that there is an ADA car on every train, improving our ADA accessibility for the public. We have, in addition to that, had multiple motor coaches that are ADA compliant, so that we no longer have to scramble if we discover we have got somebody who requires ADA assistance. We figure our on-time performance this year, arrival within 10 minutes of schedule, in Chama at over 90% and coming into Antonito at about 80%. The primary reasons that Antonito still lags a little bit has to do with some track upgrade stuff that is continuing that will then remove some slow orders and allow us to get closer to our timetable. We're proud that at this point so far there have been no medical emergencies this year. There have been no reportable passenger injuries this year. We have worked very hard this year to make sure that we have staggered arrivals and coordinate those arrivals at Osier on the busy days so as to reduce the stress on Toltec Gorge Catering at Osier for the meal service. And that has been largely successful. We have, in terms of winter work, the primary part of our winter work program this year is that locomotive number 487 will now have used up all of its available 1,472 service days and will require a complete boiler survey and rebuild this winter. That is the primary thing. There will be wheel, box, pin, and driver work on the rest of the locomotive fleet. The 463 will receive upgrades to take care of its spring hanger pin issues. We will be taking care of crosshead issues and piston ring issues as well in the course of the winter work. The annual work that we have to do on cars will continue in Antonito this winter. The mandated annual service work will continue with the passenger car upgrade program that we have started over the last several years now. We are nearing the point that we hope we'll be able to begin remodeling the original first generation passenger cars so that they begin to resemble in appearance and in service the second and third generation passenger cars. Okay. In terms of marketing and ridership,
totally
contrary. Yeah, reservation.
I'm sorry, reservations.
Manual, and I'm not going to vote.
As I say, we are at this point down. Actually, it's a little less than 3% on reservation and ridership for the year. Our tourist and parlor car ridership increased. The decrease has been in the coach ridership, and that is part of what motivates the work on the upgrade of those cars. At this time, I would like to ask Lee, I'd like you to stand up. Lee is our new marketing manager. Lee lives here in Chama, New Mexico.
Hang on just a second, Lee. Do you have some questions?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's all right. How many employees did we get up to this year?
I believe our employee count, I want to say it's 70. I don't have that number right in front of me.
Okay. With about 35 of those seasonal and 25 full-time, or how does that break down?
It breaks down at about 30, I believe it breaks down to about 30 full-time.
Okay.
And those are almost evenly split between Chama and Antonito.
Okay. And I just want to say that, having ridden the train a few times this last season, I think the ADA concession car combination is outstanding. It really worked well. It brought the concession component really into scale for what it needed to be, and it satisfies this important ADA component. So I really want to compliment you and whoever else on the design of those cars, the redesign of those cars. I think it was money very well spent. And just a request would be that you get together with the key folks on your team within the next 30 days and do a real debriefing of this season and come up with a plan of any operating changes and kind of an operating plan for next season. I think we typically wait until the springtime to put together a plan, and while it's fresh in our minds, I think it would be better. So hopefully we could ask you to do that in the next 30 days and send out a draft to the commission, but we could have that as an agenda item, a kind of debrief and operating plan for next season on the January meeting, Mr. Chairman, if that's all right with you.
That's fine.
You won't be chairman, so you don't care.
I don't care.
I hear you. Good.
We'll go
good.
To Colorado anyway.
Thank you. That's all, Mr. Chair.
Any other questions of John at this time? Okay, Lee.